So in this video, I want to show you how to remove vocals from music track. I'm using International Love by Pitbull featuring Chris Brown. Take a listen. So international. You can't catch me, boy. Can't catch me, boy. I'm overseas at about 100 G for show. Don't catch me, boy. Don't catch me, boy. Cause I rap with the... I'm gonna get into all sorts of copyright claims with using this song, but yeah, whatever. The reason why I'm using this song is because you can hear that the vocals are mixed not just in the center, but also to the sides as well. So with most vocal remover effects on Audacity or even on Adobe Audition, which we are using the center channel extractor to do this, how it works is it tries to actually attenuate the center channel levels. So that means it assumes that most songs has its vocals mixed into the center of the piece. So if I'm gonna use this effect, I can just simply use a preset and go down to vocal remove. Let's turn this effect on and let's preview how this sounds. All right, I'm gonna let you hear before and also after the effect. So international. You can't catch me, boy. Can't catch me, boy. I'm overseas at about 100 G for show. Don't catch me, boy. Don't catch me, boy. All right, and now with the effect. So you can hear that most of the center vocals are attenuated, but you can still hear the vocals that are panned to the side channels. So this is how most center channel extractor or vocal remover effects would work. So you see that the center channel levels are attenuated by 40 dB, and the frequency range here tells you which frequency range do you want to remove the vocals from. So we are actually selecting the vocal range from 120Hz up to 20,000Hz. So in fact, if we are looking at a male vocal in this piece, we can actually push this down lower, right? Because male vocals are usually around 120Hz up to maybe about 6,000Hz. Above 6,000Hz, that's when normally the harmonics and also consonants will actually be. So we can try to put it about 6,000. Now, again, with different types of audio tracks and music tracks, you might have different settings on your frequency range and also on the center channel levels. Anyway, let's hear how this sounds with these settings here. So what this does is we preserve some of the high frequencies and also all the low end frequencies below 120Hz. Now if you look at the discrimination tab, this is basically advanced features for us to smoothen out the frequency attenuation. And something that I normally use is the crossover bleed and also the phase discrimination toolbar here. I'm going to play around with it so you can hear the effects. Now, I love using the phase discrimination one because it adds a bit of smoothness as it attenuates the center channel. So once you're ready with this and once you're happy with how it sounds, just click on apply and you would have removed, basically attenuate the vocals of the music piece. Now what if you want to actually create an acapella instead of removing the vocal tracks? So within Adobe Audition, what I'm doing here is just the opposite. So instead of using the vocal remove, we're going to select and choose acapella. And notice what happens when we choose acapella. What happens is we preserve the center, but we remove the side channel levels. So take a listen. So international. You can't catch me, boy. I'm overseas at about 100 G for show. Don't catch me, boy. Cause I rap with the best for show. 305 to the death. So again, the frequency range tells us, or basically sets the range of frequencies you want to maintain within this acapella. So once you're happy with that, again, just select everything and click on apply, and there you have it, your acapella. I'm overseas at about 100 G for show. Don't catch me, boy. Now you might find the end results to be unsatisfactory, where we are actually just attenuating the vocals within a music track. And also sometimes in some cases, you might hear a lot of audio artifacts being introduced to the acapellas or your music track. This is the limitations of using an audio effect like the center channel extractor, where it is dependent on removing the center channel and also frequencies. Now, luckily, today we have the existence of AI, and we can actually leverage on AI-based vocal removers and AI stems. The way it works is the AI engine actually understands music, and with that, breaks down the audio elements, the musical elements within the music piece into separate audio stems. And this surpasses what we can do with traditional audio plugins like the center channel extraction or the vocal remover effects. Now, I'm going to be making a tutorial on that, so check out the description below to the link to that tutorial, and I'll see you there.